Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, a story by Gus C. Bays about a jury and justice. The Holdout. Starring Ross Martin. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
The jury passing on the prisoner's life may, in the sworn 12, have a thief or two guiltier than him. They try. As the bailiff of the county courthouse opened the door and let the 12 people into the jury room, it wasn't likely that any one of them remembered those words by William Shakespeare. They were locked in and they began their deliberations. But for one, Gabe Donovan, there was no need for further discussions. While the jurors studied the evidence, Gabe Donovan studied the jurors.
The moment had come to decide whether a man was guilty or not guilty to a charge of murder. Mr. Muncy, the jury foreman, collected the folded pieces of paper and sat down.
Miss Keller, would you keep count?
Yes, all right.
The first one is guilty. 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 Not guilty. Guilty. And guilty.
Well, 11-1.
One holdout.
Now what are we supposed to do?
Now? Start over, I guess.
How much time have we got?
All day.
And if we don't reach a verdict?
I guess they'll lock us up in a hotel overnight.
Well, they're not locking me up. I gotta get home tonight.
Well, then let's go over it again, folks. Someone will have to change their minds.
Mr. Donovan.
Yes, Miss Carmichael.
You've been awfully quiet.
Well, I was trying to think the way the one holdout might be thinking. Is this something we fail to consider? Possibly the matter of intent to commit murder? Was it definitely premeditated?
Avery knew his wife was with that Cy Randall fella, so he got a gun and went up there and killed him. I don't care how you spread it, that's murder.
Well, now there's more to it than that, Mr. Smith.
For instance?
Well, there's the plea of temporary insanity.
Yes, that confused me a little. The judge said we should consider temporary insanity.
What about that psychiatrist that testified? Now, he said temporary insanity was possible in this case.
But he said Clyde Avery was as sane as any of us.
Yes, but we must consider Clyde Avery's mental condition at the time of the shooting. After all the stories he'd heard about his wife and... Well, how would you feel under those conditions, Mr. Vail?
Me? What do you mean by that?
Well, I mean we're supposed to consider these things.
Avery pulled the trigger. That's intent, ain't it?
No. Oh, where is it? I wonder if I can make a phone call. I want to call my wife.
Guess I really started something.
Well, some of these people are beginning to get on my nerves. I'll be glad when it's over.
Yes, it's been a long trial.
Oh, yes. And that poor man downstairs, Clyde Avery, sitting there day after day and squirming and waiting and watching us, wondering about our verdict. Doing the best... What's the matter, Mr. Donovan?
Mrs. Carmichael, you sound like you might be the one holdout.
Me? Oh, I'm...
Don't tell me. I don't want to know. See, Mrs. Carmichael, if you are the only one who thought he wasn't guilty, well, then I've got to talk to you.
To me? Why?
It's because I'm not really sure he's guilty either.
You're not?
No. I let the others influence my thinking, but there were so many contradictions. Now, you take that business about the struggle when the gun went off.
Do you think there was a struggle?
Well, I didn't at first. But the medical examiner said the bullet entered the victim's chest traveling down. Avery would have had to hold the gun over his head, pointed down, to give the bullet that direction of travel. Like this, you see, it's ridiculous. It's too awkward. Might miss.
But the direction of the bullet was downward.
Well, then the gun went off as they both fought for it over their heads.
I see.
My verdict was wrong. It was just wrong. If you voted not guilty, you were right, Mrs. Carmichael. Trust a woman's intuition, I always say.
Yes.
You'll have allies after the next ballot, Mrs. Carmichael. You wait and see.
Do you think the others will change their minds?
Well, look at Mr. Bale.
He seems so upset.
And Mrs. Medina?
Yes, and Miss Keller, Jane. Still going over her notes.
Well, she needs help, too.
Oh, why don't you talk to her? She'll listen to you. She's very fond of you, you know.
I will. And you should help Mrs. Medina see this more clearly, too.
Poor thing. I think I will talk to her.
Good. Help her to understand, just as you've helped me, Mrs. Carmichael.
All right, I will. And I'll talk to the other ladies.
Good. Well, we can't let an innocent man go to the gas chamber. You've made me see that.
No, we can't. I'll talk to Mrs. Medina.
Stuffy in here.
Yes.
Gabe, is anything wrong?
Wrong? No, why?
You haven't said a word to me all day.
Well, Jane, we've been busy, you know, so much on our minds with the verdict.
You're not mad at me.
Of course not. Why should I be?
Because I voted the way I did.
I explained how I felt about this case last night, Jane. Made it clear so even you could understand.
I just had to vote the way I did, Gabe. Honest.
Well, then, last night was a waste of time. That's all. The other nights, too. You let the others influence you.
No, I didn't. I think he's guilty.
You think?
Well, I mean...
Don't you understand, Jane? You can't think. If a reasonable doubt exists in your mind, you can't honestly consider him guilty.
Oh, I'm so confused. I don't know what to think.
Well, then go sit in the corner, study your notes some more. It's all there in your notebook.
Well, will I see you tonight for supper or something?
I don't know. They may lock us up for tonight.
Will they do that?
If we can't agree.
You aren't going to change your verdict.
I'd jump out of this window first.
You really believe Clyde Avery is innocent, don't you? I wish we could have met some other way instead of here. I think I'll go over my notes again.
Anything wrong with Miss Keller, Dunman?
Hmm? No.
I was hoping we could talk a little before I took the next ballot.
Well, the bailiff will be up soon. Maybe we'd better take a ballot first, see how it's going.
Maybe you're right. Folks, can I have your attention, please? I think we should try another ballot before lunch. Now, if you'll just sit down, please. As before, choose either guilty or not guilty. And fold your ballots and pass them down to me, please. Mr. Dunman, you might keep count as I read them.
Absolutely.
All right. Have I got all the ballots now?
I think so.
All right, then. Guilty. 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 Not guilty. 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 Not guilty.
Not
guilty.
What?
Not guilty.
Oh, no.
8-4. Still a hung jury.
My verdict was clear. Clyde Avery was not guilty. The others simply had to see it my way, or I was neglecting my duty as a juror.
Donovan, is that clock right?
Maybe a little slow, Mr. Bale.
What's Muncie waiting for? Why don't we get started?
They've started.
Donovan, what do you think? Are we going to get out of here tonight?
Well, I wouldn't bet on it.
What do you mean?
Some of the jurors are changing their minds.
Why can't they get together on a verdict?
Would it help to talk about it, you think?
Look. It's my wife, Edna. We've been arguing. She said she was going to leave me.
Well, leaving her alone tonight might give her a chance to think it all over, maybe.
If I'm not home tonight, she'll think I don't care, and there's another man.
Oh.
You see why I gotta get out of here tonight, don't you?
Yes, of course. But so many of them are changing their minds. I'll be honest with you, Vale. I'm changing my verdict on the next ballot, too.
Then talk to them, Donovan. They'll listen to you. These people got a lot of respect for you. One way or the other, get them to agree. Please. What am I going to do?
Say, Donovan, I want to talk to you. You keep harping on that temporary insanity. You one of them that voted for an acquittal?
Well, I don't mind telling you how I voted. I did change my mind on that last ballot.
I thought so.
You know why?
Nope.
Because I believe a man can go insane temporarily. A man's mind is a complex instrument. A small thing can unbalance it, upset a man's reasoning. And it can happen just like that.
Just like that, eh?
Could happen to anyone. You, me, Mr. Muncie, even Mr. Vale over there.
Well, I have to see it before I believe it.
I'm not trying to change your mind, Mr. Smith. Only you can do that. I changed mine. We're all trying the best we can.
What's he doing?
Who?
Mr. Vale. He rang the buzzer for the bailiff.
I don't know. There's the bailiff.
Somebody ring for me?
I did, bailiff. I wonder if I could make a short phone call.
No, sir. I'm...
Wait, look, I just want to call my wife.
Well, the judge won't permit it, sir. I'm sorry.
I won't mention the trial. You can listen in if you want.
Well, there's nothing I can do until you've brought in a verdict. I'm sorry.
We may be here all night.
Well, then we'll have to lock you up, sir.
No. No, you're not locking me up tonight. Hey, what's the matter with you?
I want out of here.
Let go of me.
Tell him
about it.
Tell him
about it.
Let me go.
Please.
Yes. We can handle it. Now, I hope this is not going to cause any trouble.
No. It's all right. Just keep him quiet.
Here. I brought the poor man a drink of water.
Well, I don't want a drink of water.
Just leave me alone.
No, I've never seen anything like it. He was just sitting there, minding his own business, and then...
And then, just like that, it happened.
Went plumb crazy.
Temporary insanity, Mr. Smith? All afternoon, I joined small groups around the room. They were like weather vanes. They'd go whichever way the wind seemed to be blowing. Mr. Muncie?
Yes?
Don't you think it's time for another ballot?
Well, the others want one.
Yes.
All right, then. All right. But this time, we'll have an open ballot with a show of hands, unless you have any objections, Mr. Dunham.
Objections? No, not at all, Mr. Muncie.
All right. Now, then, if everybody's in their place, fine. Each person in favor of a verdict of not guilty, raise your right hand. Dunham, you count them.
All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 votes in favor of an acquittal.
Oh,
11.
Okay. And in favor of a verdict of guilty,
one vote.
11-1. One holdout.
Oh, no.
And now you know who it is, Mr. Donovan. See if you can make me change my mind.
Mr. Muncie, I can't make you change your mind. Only you can do that. Each of us must vote the way he believes.
Yes, well, I still believe that this was a planned and premeditated act of murder, and the evidence proves it.
Well, you're the only one who thinks so, Mr. Muncie. The only holdout.
You can't say a reasonable doubt doesn't exist. It does. So how can you say he's guilty?
Yes, all of us want to do the right thing. You must be wrong.
We could be out of here in a minute. If you change your verdict, Muncie.
I think it's a case of temporary insanity. Clear cut.
Mr. Muncie, it isn't a sin to admit that you were wrong. Now, all of us searched our hearts and realized our mistake, and we changed our minds.
You changed your minds. You.
Yes.
Why, your minds were changed for you. You were led like a bunch of blind sheep. And there is your good shepherd, Mr. Donovan.
Look, Muncie,
I saw you talking to him, confusing him, convincing him that they were wrong before, getting them to change their verdict.
You don't know what you're talking about.
No? Well, I'm not much at talking, I'll admit that. Oh, but you are, Donovan. You talked these people right out of an honest verdict. You thought you were right, so everybody else had to see it your way.
You're crazy.
Crazy? Donovan, you... You think a lot of yourself, don't you? Oh, I've known men like you before. They think the world revolves around them. Egocentrics. Always think they're right. Never admit they're wrong.
Now, look, Muncie, I've had about enough of this.
You're more than an egocentric, Donovan. You're an egomaniac. That's why you made everyone change their minds. You can't admit that you're wrong, can you? No, not your kind. If you did, you'd begin to wonder about other things, about yourself. And your ego can't have that, can it, Donovan? You're the one who's crazy.
You can't talk to me that way, Muncie.
No, I'm just getting started. Look, I'm going to talk and keep talking. At least people get a chance to do what grace. What is it, Bayless?
You folks can go home now. The jury has been dismissed.
What?
Yeah, that's right.
You have to come back.
You see, Clyde Avery broke down a few minutes ago and pleaded guilty to the charge.
Wow. He pleaded guilty?
Uh-huh. He admitted lying on the stand. Asked for the court's mercy by confessing.
But he couldn't have.
Well, he did.
But our verdict was...
We won't need it now, ma'am.
It's all over?
That's right. You folks can leave.
I gotta get home. Wait, folks, before you go, Mrs. Carmichael.
You've said enough.
But, Mr. Smith, listen.
I'm sorry, Donovan.
Just wait, please, folks, let me explain. Miss Gil, please, Jane.
Get lost, Buster.
Jane, wait, if you'll only let me... Explain.
Yeah. You made them all very proud of themselves, Donovan.
Muncie, I...
Will you admit that you were wrong now, Donovan?
I was right.
You were
right.
I was right.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes, exercise your imagination, and join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
The Holdout is an original radio drama by Gus C. Bates. Russ Martin was heard as Gabe Donovan. Featured in the cast were Parley Bear, Mary Lansing, Marvin Kaplan, Jane Webb, and Byron King. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Collis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman. Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.